In this video, we will discuss about different fluid properties such as surface tension, capillary action or capillarity, and compressibility of fluid. First one is surface tension. The surface tension is the tendency of liquid surfaces at rest to shrink into minimum surface area possible. For example, a small droplets of fluid are spherical due to surface tension because molecules of water tend to stick together due to intermolecular force, and the energy of molecules that are located on the surface of droplets contains higher energy and try to push other molecule to the center of droplet. Due to this, the drop makes the shape that contains least surface area, and the spherical shape is the best for least surface area. That's why the droplets of water are spherical. That means surface tension is the property of surface of liquid that allows it to resist an external force due to cohesive nature of its molecules. Surface tension depends upon the forces of attraction between particles within the given liquid and also upon the gas, solid or liquid in contact with it. Mathematically, the surface tension is defined as the ratio of force acting on surface and length of surface. Here F is the force measured in Newton and L is the length measured in meter. Hence the unit of surface tension is Newton per meter. There are various methods which are used to measure the surface tension of any liquid. The capillary rise method consists of a tube whose radius is very short and uniform, called as capillary tube, and this capillary tube is dipped into liquid which is to be tested. In case of water, the strength of adhesive forces are larger than the strength of cohesive forces. This results in concave formation of water in capillary tube. This is called as capillary attraction. And alternatively, for mercury, the cohesive forces are stronger than the adhesive forces, which allows meniscus to bend away from the walls of capillary tube. This is called as capillary repulsion. Here cohesive force is the intermolecular bonding of a substance where its mutual attractiveness forces them to maintain a very certain shape of liquid. And when forces of attraction between unlike molecules occurs, it is called as adhesive forces. The rise of liquid level in capillary tube is called as capillary rise, whereas the fall of liquid surface in capillary tube is called as capillary depression, and it is expressed in terms of centimeter or millimeter of liquid. This phenomenon of rise or fall of liquid level in capillary tube is called as capillarity, and it is also known as capillary action or capillary effect or capillary motion. The magnitude of capillarity is dependent upon diameter of tube small d, specific weight of liquid gamma, the contact angle theta, and surface tension of liquid capital S. The magnitude of capillarity, that is height of liquid rised or decreased in capillary tube, indicated as small h, is given by the formula, that is 4s cos theta divided by gamma into small d, where theta is contact angle. For pure water, the contact angle will be 0, and for mercury, the contact angle will be 140 degrees. The next term is compressibility. The compressibility is defined as the variation of volume or density with respect to pressure with constant mass. In simple words, compressibility is the measure of how much given volume changes instantaneously when placed under pressure. If variation of volume with respect to pressure is high, then compressibility is high. Mathematically, compressibility is defined as the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity, where bulk modulus is defined as the ratio of direct stress to volumetric strain. In fluid mechanics, the direct stress is hydrostatic stress, and volumetric strain is the ratio of change in volume to original volume, that is equal to minus Vdp upon dV. Here P is pressure and V is volume. Therefore, compressibility equal to 1 upon K, and after simplifying, this will get formula for compressibility, that is minus dV upon V into dP. Here minus sign is needed to assure that an increase in applied external pressure will result in decrease in volume of object. The effect of pressure on change in volume in case of liquids is negligible. For this reason, water and other liquids are considered incompressible, while the gases are compressible.